this video, I am going to explain projectile motion. If an object is thrown with an initial velocity and then it is allowed to move under the action of gravity, then it is known as projectile motion. There are two types of projectile motion. If the object is given a velocity in the horizontal direction, then it is called horizontal projection. Or if it is thrown at a particular angle with the horizontal, then it is called oblique projection. Example for projectile motion: a ball or a stone thrown from the window of a moving train, or a bullet fired from a rifle, or a ball thrown in any direction. These are all examples for projectile motion. There are two types of projectile motion. One is horizontal projection and oblique projection. First, let us see horizontal projection. Here, an object is thrown in the horizontal direction with an initial velocity ux. Then it is moving under two velocity. It has got two velocities. It is moving in the horizontal direction with a uniform velocity. If you neglect the air resistance, there is no force in the horizontal direction. So uniform horizontal velocity will be a constant. When it is reaching here also, it will be ux. When it is here also, ux. So horizontal velocity will remain constant. Then vertical velocity will be going on increasing during the downward motion. So that is uy. Initially, velocity in the vertical direction is zero. So ux, velocity in the horizontal direction remains constant. During the, if you are throwing at a particular angle, during the upward motion, velocity will be going on decreasing, and during the downward motion, velocity is going on increasing. So the vertical velocity will be going on changing, either increasing or decreasing. Now x is equal to ux into t, where x is the distance covered in the horizontal direction. Horizontal velocity remains constant, so you can write x is equal to ux into t. Then displacement in the vertical direction is y is equal to uyt plus half gt square, where uy is the initial velocity in the vertical direction. Initial velocity in the vertical direction is zero. We are projecting in the horizontal direction, so initial velocity in the vertical direction is zero. So this term is zero. So y is equal to half gt square. Then for this t, you can get from this expression, t is equal to x by ux. For this t, you can write x by ux, then it's square. Y is equal to half g x square by ux square. Now this can be written like this: g divided by 2 ux square. That's a constant. Acceleration due to gravity, u initial velocity in the velocity in the horizontal direction, so it's a constant. So we can write y is equal to k x square. This is the equation of a parabola. The path traced by a projectile is called a trajectory. Then trajectory of a projectile motion is a parabola. This is the equation of a parabola, y is equal to k x square. Now let us see the time of flight. Time of flight is the time taken by the projectile to complete the motion, or time taken by the body to hit the ground. S is equal to ut plus half at square. Since it is moving in the vertical direction, you can write as y. Velocity in the vertical direction, uy. You are throwing horizontally. That means initial velocity in the vertical direction is zero. So this term is zero. Then since it is moving in the vertical direction, instead of sy, you can write h. So h is equal to half gt square. For time of flight, instead of small t, you write capital T. From this, we can write t square is equal to 2h by g. So time of flight is equal to square root of 2h by g. That means time of flight depends on the height. Height from which you are throwing the body. Now, let us find horizontal range. The distance covered by the body in the horizontal direction. S is equal to ut plus half a t square. Here, since it is moving in the horizontal direction, you can write as x ux. Distance covered in the horizontal direction, that is the range. So for this sx, you can write r. Then half a t square. Here there is no acceleration in the horizontal direction, so acceleration is zero. Then ux is u. So this acceleration is zero, so this term will become zero. So for sx, you can write r, horizontal range. Ux, horizontal velocity remains constant and it is equal to the initial velocity in the horizontal direction. So ux, you can write u. Then instead of t, small t, you can write capital T, where capital T is the time of flight that you have already seen. Time of flight is square root of 2h by g. So horizontal range is u into square root of 2h by g. Next, we'll see resultant velocity. At each point on the trajectory, there will be a resultant velocity. It's a combination of two velocity. Velocity in the horizontal direction is vx. Velocity along the y-axis or the vertical direction is vy. Velocity along the horizontal direction remains constant. It is ux. Initially u, then velocity in the horizontal direction remains constant, ux. So velocity in the horizontal direction, vx is equal to ux plus axt. There is no acceleration in the horizontal direction, so ax is zero. Ux, velocity in the horizontal direction remains constant. So instead of ux, you can write u, acceleration zero. So velocity along the horizontal direction remains constant, so vx is same as u. Now velocity in the vertical direction is vy, is uy plus ayt square. Then you are throwing the body in the horizontal direction, so initial velocity in the vertical direction is zero, so uy is zero. Then ay, acceleration in the vertical direction is acceleration due to gravity. So since uy is zero, you will get to vy is equal to gt. Ay, you can write g. So vy is gt. So vy is gt. Vx is u. X. Vx. Vx is ux. But that is same as initial velocity u. Now, its resultant is given by this v. Resultant velocity v. It is a diagonal of this rectangle. Then we can get v is equal to square root of vx square plus vy square. Vx is u. So it is square root of u square plus g square t square. Instead of vy square, you can write g square t square. So this is the resultant velocity. Now let us find the speed of the projectile when it hits the ground. Projectile means the object thrown. If you are throwing the ball, ball is the projectile. When it is hitting the ground, what is the speed? You have seen resultant velocity is given by square root of vx square plus vy square. Vx is the velocity in the horizontal direction, Vy. Vy is gt. G is the acceleration due to gravity. When it is hitting the ground, time of flight. So instead of small t or right, capital T. So Vy is g capital T. G, time of flight is square root of 2h by g. When you take this g inside, the square root g square, then that g and this g will get cancelled. So g. So when it is hitting the ground, vertical velocity is square root of 2h g. Resultant velocity is square root of vx square plus vy square. So for vx, you can write u, square root of u square plus for vy square, you can write 2hg when you square it, vy square. So vy square, you can write 2hg. So this is the speed of the projectile when it is hitting the ground. So resultant velocity is a combination of two velocity. Velocity along the x-axis is u, so ui cap plus velocity along the y-axis is gt, so gt j cap. So resultant velocity can be written as v vector is equal to ui cap plus gt j cap. Thank you for watching.